Hey y'all, I'm Chef Scott with Superb Farms and this is Test Kitchen Tuesday. Hey, it's October 13th. We've got some great color going on up here in the mountains. Leaves are starting to change. But October is, wait for it, National Pizza Month. That's right. So today, I'm going to do two pizza concepts. The first one I'm going to do is featuring our brand new product, a creamy roasted garlic sauce. This product is so awesome. It can be used as a sandwich spread. It can be used to toss vegetables in to create a great roast of vegetables, or it can be used as a pizza sauce. So today we're going to make a steak and cheese pizza with a creamy garlic sauce. And then the next pizza we're going to do is something even more unique. We're going to make a tikki masala pizza, a chicken tikki masala pizza. We're going to serve that on naan bread, and that features the Indian masala paste by Superb Farms. You get some really great blend of spices in this. Not too overly hot, but really, really great tikki masala or gram masala flavors. So we're going to make a tikki masala chicken pizza with some homemade paneer cheese that I made on Saturday and some fresh mango and spinach. So it's all coming to you next. Let's head back to the kitchen. Hey y'all, today in the Test Kitchen, it's National Pizza Month, and that's really exciting because I get to work with a couple of our new products that are what we're calling ready-to-use products, or as I like to say, they are chef's flavor savers. They can save any dish. You go straight from the container, add it to whatever you're producing, whatever dish you have, and it makes incredible great flavors. There's no adding it to anything to create a new sauce. This is a ready-to-go product. So the two that we're showing today, I talked about earlier, is this beautiful, great roast, creamy roasted garlic. It's a great product. Can be used in pasta salads in place of mayonnaise. It can be used on top of chicken to make a beautiful creamy garlic glaze. And as we're going to use today as a bottom, as a pizza sauce for the pizza. And then the other product I want to show you today is our bruschetta paste. Now, a couple weeks ago, I showed you our bruschetta blend, which was a dry blend that you would take and you add your own olive oil and your own balsamic vinegar and such to create a bruschetta. We came up, we also have a bruschetta paste, and the bruschetta paste, it's got some really great, it's got reduced moisture tomatoes in it. It's got some basil, oregano. It's just basically the bruschetta blend that's already produced. So you don't have to have any labor involved. So today I'm going to do a steak and cheese pizza, and I'm going to use the creamy roasted garlic as the bottom. And then we're going to put little dollops of the bruschetta around it, along with some other great ingredients. So let's go through the ingredients. Okay, these are the ingredients for our steak and cheese pizza with a creamy garlic sauce. So here are the stars of the show. Of course, we talked about this great creamy roasted garlic. Oh man, that stuff is so awesome. And then here is our bruschetta paste. We're just putting little dollops of that on there. We have some fresh mozzarella. I have some beef tenderloin that I have sliced very, very thin. And then we are going to just lay that on there and let it finish cooking on the pizza so it will be nice and juicy. Then we have some caramelized onions and poblanos and then mushrooms. And of course I have a little par-baked pizza crust that I made and we just par-baked it off. All right, let's get started.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
Now into a 450 degree oven until it's bubbly hot and GBD, golden brown delicious.
Yeah. Ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella.
So the next pizza I'm doing is going to be an Indian-inspired pizza, and we're going to make it on naan bread. And I'm going to create it using the Indian masala paste by Superb Farms. This is one of the culinary paste by Superb Farms, so it's a little more intense flavors than the sauces that we looked at earlier that we're ready to use. So this is more of an ingredient. It comes in frozen and it has a 60-day refrigerated shelf life. So the great thing about these products are you just take them, you add them to other ingredients, and you create a signature sauce or signature spread. Today we're going to make a signature Indian masala, like a gram or tikki masala sauce for our pizza. Very quick and very easy, I'm gonna make it. The first thing is I got a quarter cup of our pre-made marinara sauce. Just add that to your sauce pot. Then I have 2 tablespoons of whole milk Greek yogurt. And we're gonna add this to our pot. And then we're gonna add 1 tablespoon of this great Indian masala. It's so awesome. Such floral flavors, really beautiful. So we're gonna put a nice tablespoon of that in. I'm just gonna mix this up. And what I'm gonna do next is then I'm gonna put it on the eye, just get a little heat to it so it'll warm it up so it'll spread really easy on the pizza. So while I put this on the eye, let's go through the other ingredients in the pizza today. Okay, here's the ingredients for our tikki masala chicken pizza. The sauce that I made here, using the Indian masala, the pre-made marinara, and a Greek yogurt. Here's our toppers. We have some fresh sauteed spinach, some paneer cheese. I made this cheese on Saturday. If you want to see a video of that, let me know. Some diced mangoes from my friends over at Dole. These are the chef cut diced mangoes, beautiful product. And here is some cooked chicken that was marinated in the Indian masala and some lime juice. And then of course, our pre-made naan bread. So this is gonna be our naan pizza. Let's get it going.
Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Now into a 450 degree oven until it's golden brown delicious.
Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Yeah, I want to thank you again for joining me for this episode of Test Kitchen Tuesday, brought to you by Superb Farms, the number one name in culinary herbs and culinary paste. If you want to see that great creamy roasted garlic or even that bruschetta paste in the Indian masala, be sure to leave me a message below and I'll be sure to get you a sample. Or as always, you can reach out to your Superb Farms county executive. So until next time, keep on making great food.